any of you have ever tried to play the guitar or any instrument, or tried to play the blues or even heard the blues, you know that it's honestly pretty boring. Like, it's not, definitely not the most interesting type of music. But if any of you have seen the movie Back to the Future, you know that there's that one scene at the end where he goes back in time to his parents' high school dance in the 50s, and the main singer and guitar player of the band at the dance, he like breaks his hand or something, and so he has to go up on stage and he plays the guitar. And in the 50s, it wasn't common to hear blues music publicly because it was mainly only black people played it. And so he gets up and he plays the song Johnny Be Good by Chuck Berry, which is mainly like a rock and roll blues song. And so everyone just kind of like looked at him like it was really weird and nobody liked it. But it was just an example of how in the 50s it was so segregated that if you were white, you didn't listen to blues music, even though in the future it would like advance and become the main type of music that would be like the roots of all the other genres. So whether you're in the car or at home or at school listening on your AirPods, it could be Lil Yachty to Frank Sinatra. You listen to music all the time and it's everywhere. And most people don't know that the blues is the roots of most all types of music. So to know why it's so important to every genre of music, you want to know where it started. So interestingly, it started with the slaves in the early 1900s, and it was actually a really risky thing to do because it developed in the slaves in the fields, and they wanted to escape, obviously, and so they created this way of communication with each other to not let the slave masters know what they were talking about. And they would communicate to each other in lines and songs, and it would actually lead to them telling each other where to meet for the Underground Railroad to escape, and without having the slave masters know what they were talking about. In the early 1900s, Robert Johnson was, there were other ones, but he was the main blues guy that was the first like recorded blues artist, and he made the format for all blues to come. So he made the 12-bar blues, which is what all blues music is basically, and he recorded it on acoustic guitar. And in that time period, since white people didn't listen to blues music, not many people, it wasn't that heard of, so not many people like developed more on it. But in the southern towns like Mississippi and Louisiana, where they played blues music often, people like Muddy Waters and B.B. King and Chuck Berry, they turned the acoustic blues of Robert Johnson and turned it into the electric blues, and they often played it in a band with like guitar and bass and drums. So these guys were the early pioneers of blues music in the early 1900s. And then people came along like Elvis Presley in the 50s, who they took blues music that they listened to their childhood and they turned it into their own music. And what Elvis did, which was so important, is that he took blues music and he covered a lot of the songs, which can be controversial because people say that he like stole black music. But if he wouldn't have covered the songs and gotten it to the top of the billboards, then who knows if people would have actually kept listening to the blues music if he didn't integrate it into the modern pop that white people listen to and got it on the radio. And actually his first like hit song, called That's Alright, it's actually a cover of a blues song that made it to the number 2 Billboard charts. So that really took off the blues music. And then after Elvis, he really opened the doors for all white musicians to play blues and make it seem more open instead of looked down upon since it was being played amongst blacks. And people like Eric Clapton really took the blues and took it to other genres like rock and roll, because Eric Clapton was in several bands like the Yardbirds and Cream and Derek and the Dominoes, and he turned the blues into like psychedelic rock and blues rock and other things like that. And he made it more of he took the blues to rock, and that led to all the bands that we know today like Led Zeppelin and Rolling Stones and stuff. Another thing that boosted blues music was the civil rights movement, because people like Bob Dylan right there and other blues musicians, they created civil rights songs, and instead of protesting like at rallies like you see right there, they would write songs, and that would be their way of protesting and music popularity. And then after the civil rights, after many people protested and everything, and people started recognizing these artists more, people like Buddy Guy and Helen Wolf started getting popularity, even though they've been around for so a long time, or they've been playing for a long time already, they hadn't been recognized. But after the civil rights, they started being looked at by other musicians, and bands like Stevie Ray Vaughan and Rolling Stones and Led Zeppelin, they often have like a lot of covers of blues songs that are just rock versions, but people don't know because some people say they stole it, but it often just boosted the popularity of blues music so that when people listen to it and look more into it, they realize that it's actually just blues from the 50s that they're covering. So that's just rock music, but blues took on, blues developed into other genres like funk, and then funk turned to soul like Aretha Franklin, and then soul turned to hip-hop. And hip-hop artists in like the early 90s and 80s, like Wu-Tang Clan and N.W.A. and stuff like that, they got their sound because they used the 12-bar blues often, and then just put tracks on it with other effects. Alright, and then blues today, you probably know people like John Mayer, or the Black Keys, or Jack Johnson. And these are just people today that play straight blues. And like John Mayer, for example, he really was a fan of Stevie Ray Vaughan. And so if you like John Mayer, you know that he does like at his shows like often like covers of like Jimi Hendrix and stuff like that, and just straight blues. And the Black Keys are just new blues, and so is Jack Johnson. And so that's how it has its roots in all the other types of genres of music. So I encourage you, for the next time you listen to music, that when you're listening to it, see if you can find elements of the blues, like the 12-bar or things like that.